Good afternoon, my dear respected students. Today we are supposed to discuss the content related to a CSV file. Can you please just tell me the full form of CSV if you don't mind? Comma separated values. Very good. Great. Hope you remember something. Today I'm just going to discuss question number 40. Last question of your question paper, that is CS 083. 083 is a code representing a computer science. And my dear respected students, this question is of 5 marks, which is very, very important. And here it is, the combination of binary and CSV file is to be considered here, whether you are supposed to do the binary file or whether there is a file that is CSV. Question is, it's my humble request, you all are requested to kindly concentrate here on this screen. And after that, we are supposed to do the practical also. This question says, consider the following CSV file. For example, this time I'm just going to change the name. That is, for example, 14 CSV. And CSV, you all know that comma separated values. Here it is, we having a structure of that particular CSV file. In structure, we having very important thing here, my dear respected students. And that important thing is the structure. That is, I think so, we can consider here if there is a confusion. So we are supposed to mention here, in spite of something other than this, we are supposed to mention R number, name, and marks. This is basically the structure. And what we are going to do here, we are going to write a function that is a display student to read the content of a student. Here it is. Again, we are going to make the modification student14.csv and display only those records where marks is 40 or above. My dear respected students, kindly concentrate here. We have today we are discussing a CSV. Ek bar dobara bol dijiye. CSV stands for comma separated values. And my dear respected students, the structure of that particular file where we have roll number, next we have name, and last we have marks. Very good, great. And we are supposed to create a function which is called as a display student, and the criteria or the constraint is that we are only display the information of those where the marks is 40 or above. It means 40 or greater than 40. It's my humble request. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about a binary file. My dear respected students, can I acknowledge something? Can I recap something? In binary file, we have in the dash module.
Import picker.
But in CSV, we having a module import CSV. Very good, great. In binary file, we having two different options. First is read and second is write. For reading, we have load. And for write,
dump.
Are wah. But in case of a CSV file, for reading, we have a function which is to be called as a reader. And for writing, we have a writer. And along with the writer, we are supposed to use a function that is to be called as a write row or write rows. If we are supposed to write a single row one time, in such case, we use write row. And for multiple lines, we have a write row. मेरे प्यारे बच्चों, अगर आपको इतनी बात समझ आ गई, इसका मतलब है आपको CSV समझ आ गई. But in as per this question, they are only talking about that you are supposed to make one function, that is a display student. But no, for better understanding, we are supposed to make an entire program where we are supposed to enter something, we are supposed to display the entire content, and then we are supposed to display the content as per the criteria. मेरे प्यारे बच्चों, कृपया करके ध्यान को एकाग्रचित कीजिए. इट्स माय हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट. Okay, here it is. The description of that particular program. I hope this concept is clear to all. My dear students, first of all, we are supposed to import a module that is to be called as a CSV. After that, for inserting a data, I am going to make a function that is to be called as a input one, where as similar what we are going to do with a binary file, we are first of all, we are supposed to open a file. Where this is to be this obj1, my dear respected students, this obj1 is to be considered as a object. Okay, where with the help of that particular, we are supposed to open the file that is a student14.csv, w representing a write, and new line is representing EOL. Mere beta, EOL kya hota hai? End of line. And by default, for Windows, we having two things which representing a EOL. First is to be called as a slash N. And second is to be called as a slash R. That is a carriage return or a new line. Next thing, my dear respected students, when we move forward for writing purpose with the CSV, rather than writing as in binary file, for writing purpose, we are using a function that is to be called as a dump. But in case of CSV, we are using a function which is to be called as a writer. And CSV representing a module, and this w_obj1 is to be considered as a writer object. क्या बोलेंगे बेटा इसको? Writer object. अब मेरा काम हुआ क्या? मैंने फाइल ओपन कर ली. फाइल ओपन करने के लिए मैंने राइट करना स्टार्ट किया उसमें, और उसके लिए मैंने एक राइटर ऑब्जेक्ट बना दिया. हो गया, इट्स ऑल डन. रेस्ट विल सेम एज वी आर डूइंग इन अ बाइनरी. Here it is, we are expecting a value that is a roll number, that is a name, and that is a marks. For, here it is, for roll number, we having a data type that is an int. For name, we having a string. And for marks, we having a float. Similar way, we are going to use a variable which is to be called as a data. And here it is, we are supposed to store all the values and make data a list. Maine usko list bana diya. After that, for writing, what we are going to do here, we are using a function that is to be called as a write row. Beta, when we use write row, they write one row or a multiple row?
One
row. Or if we write rows, in such case, we write a multiple rows. Very good. Great. Here it is. Because we have entered in an infinite loop, which we have mentioned here, that is a while true. For stopping that infinite loop, we are supposed to impose a particular constraint. And in that case, my dear respected students, what we are going to do here is, we have mentioned that choice. You are supposed to enter your choice. Agar, if your choice not in Y or Y, then they are going to break. Wo kya karega? Aapke program ko kya karega, bachcho?
Break.
Aur break hone ke baad, your data is going to be inserted, entered, while we write obj1 dot. कॉन्टेंट अच्छा, अगर आप कॉन्टेंट रीड कर रहे हो तो पहले मैंने रीड फंक्शन लिया. सबसे पहले क्या करूंगा, फाइल को पहले ऊपर रीडर ऑब्जेक्ट बनाया था, अब कौन सा, सॉरी पहले राइटर था, अब कौन सा,
रीडर.
और हम उसको डाटा को रीड कर सकते हैं. देखिएगा कृपया करके, I'm going to mention here, my dear respected students, we are going to open that particular file, and here it is. I'm just going to make changes in the name of the file, that is a student14.csv, or this time representing a read. Very. After that, csv.reader and r_obj1 is called as a reader object. With the help of a loop for I in r_obj1 print I. It means we are going to display the entire content which is there in file, that is student14.csv. अच्छा अब हमने क्या किया, लास्ट फंक्शन सेज डिस्प्ले स्टूडेंट्स विच इज द एक्चुअल आंसर ऑफ अवर क्वेश्चन व्हाट वी रिक्वायर्ड एक्चुअली. हियर इट इज अगेन द कॉन्सेप्ट विल बी सेम student14.csv एंड इन अ रीडिंग मोड क्रिएटिंग अ ऑब्जेक्ट. माय डियर रिस्पेक्टेड स्टूडेंट, आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू मेक दिस अ कमेंट एंड I want that error will occur or display on the screen, and then we are supposed to discuss that what is the functioning of that particular thing. Here it is. After that, we are looking forward. Okay. There is a loop, and on index number 0, mera beta, index number 0 pe kya nazar aayega aap logon ko? Roll number. Index 1 pe kya aayega? Name. Index 2 pe kya aayega? Very good. Marks. So, here we are going to apply if now let error occurs. I'm just going to mention here because as per my question, I am looking forward for a mark. So the index value will be 2. And what I am going to do here, marks is greater than is equal to 40. And let display the output. I'm just going to remove. हाँ जी बेटा, एक बार error already दीजिएगा केशव जी, हम देखेंगे फिर उसके बाद आपसे विचार विमर्श करेंगे जो भी होना चाहिए या जो expected है. Okay, it's fine. I'm just going to run that particular program. Hit the enter key, my dear respected students. They just asked for the values. I'm just going to enter the values. Roll number 1. Okay, here it is. My student, that is Dev. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अच्छा मार्क्स के बारे में कंसर्न मत करिएगा. आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू अदरवाइज आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू एंटर द मार्क्स. हिट द एंटर अगेन. रोल नंबर 2. ओके केशव, और मैंने मार्क्स दिए 45. वन मोर स्टूडेंट, हियर इट इज मेरा प्यारा शिष्य, और आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू एंटर उससे भी एक प्यारा रह गया है, दो रह गए सॉरी उससे प्यारे, मैंने कर दिया 67, and I am just going to hit the enter, and now I am just going to insert a n. Remember, if choice not in y, then what happen? Break. So the program will be terminated. Now it's my humble request that kindly concentrate, my dear respected students. What happen here? The content when the read one. When we talk about a read one, here it is, my dear respected student, the read one function happens, they display the content as it is. They display the content as it is. Rule number 1, Dev, Keshav and Manveer, the entire content will be displayed. But what happened next, my dear respected student, kindly concentrate. It says type error, okay. Not supported between instances of string and int. My dear respected student, why it happens? Why it happens? Because as you remember that we have inserting a header here, and what happens when we insert that header, first of all within a file, all these things representing a data type that is to be called as string. 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 And they ask that they are unable to convert that string into the data type that is a float. So if you want to make a correction in such case, first of all, we are supposed to skip that. And second thing, what we are going to make a change is that in spite of writing anything, we are supposed to write a float which represent that particular data. मेरे बच्चों को मेरी बात समझ आ गई थी? मैंने क्या किया? What I am going to do here, my dear respected students, first of all, now what I am going to do, I am just going to stop this function and this function also. Here it is. This print says next reader object. Okay. And after that, what happened? I'm just going to mention here, my dear respected students, FLOAT float. After that, there is a circular bracket. Then again, there is a circular bracket. Okay. Two representing a marks. And after that, what they are going to do, they are supposed to display the content. I'm just going to run that particular, and hopefully the content, actual content, is going to be displayed on the screen. Mere bachcho ko meri screen pe nazar aa gaya. Acha, ab ek aur change. I'm just going to make the changes here. Now this time, I just want to make an alteration in the constraint. I want to display the information of only those students where roll number is greater than is equal to 2. So can you please just guide me related the same where I'm just going to make the changes. Sab log bolenge, sabko aata hai. Okay, in spite of writing float, what we are going to write here? Int. Very good. Why so? Because roll number representing a data type, that is int. In spite of writing 2, what we are going to write, dear student? 0. Wow. And here it is greater than is equal to 40 ki jagah kya jayega? 2. And I'm just going to press the F5, hit the enter key, and my dear respected students, the information of roll number 2 and 3 is going to be appear. Okay, one more change. I just want to display the data of only one student, and here it is, the name is Manveer. Can you please guide me for the same? What I'm going to do here? Okay, just tell me. Int is required?
No.
I'm just going to delete the int. Okay, it's all done. I is 0 or something other than this? 1. Why, Ramitji, why 1? 1 representing a name. Very good. Great. I'm going to mention here and removing that circular bracket. And this time, here it is a equality operator. And I'm just going to mention Manveer. And I'm just going to press F5 and hit the enter key. Aur mere bachcho, aap agar yahan pe gaur se dekhenge, to ye information aapko nazar aa gayi. Jisko meri baat samajh aayi ho, mujhe yes or no mein answer dijiyega.
Yes.
Very good. Ek baar repeat kar lijiye. For CA, for binary, we required a module.
Picker.
For CSV.
CSV.
For in binary, for reading.
Load.
And for reading, load. And for writing, in CSV, for reading, for writing, along with right row or right row. मेरे बच्चों को सबको मेरी बात समझ आ गई. And thank you very much for your kind cooperation. आपका आने का और यहाँ आके cooperate कर